radio record for the city of Peabody, conducted by Inland Potable Services. Today and tomorrow we will be inspecting 5 tanks. First of the 5 is going to be a 236,000 gallon steel on-grade standpipe. Before entering the tank, the diver and equipment are going to be disinfected with a minimum of 200 parts per million chlorine solution. While the diver's inside the tank, he's going to use clock references to reference his position in the tank. 12 to 3 is quadrant 1, 3 to 6 is quadrant 2, so on and so forth. This way we know where the diver is. The diver's in there, he's going to tell us the depth of the sediment and also note any problems. This time we'll go ahead and pause, allow the diver to enter the tank. Once he's in the tank, we'll come back on to start today's activities. Alright, we're coming on right now. The diver's inside the tank. He's going to go through the inspection right now.
Alright, we're here at the 12 o'clock position. Taking a look at the wall. Do have a light sift of sediment on the wall, as you can see right there. Rest of the coating condition appears to be in good condition. As we get towards the foot of the wall seam, I'm going to hang up a little bit here so we don't start the sediment. We can see a little bit of corrosion starting by that forward wall seam. A couple of nodules here on the wall panel itself. And then again up a little higher. Everything looking to be very good condition. Just a slight sift of staining. And again, by that forward wall seam, you can see a little bit of corrosion nodule starting. Here we are at the 3 o'clock.
Got a good shot.
We are our first man way.
Yeah, great shot.
Okay, we have a slight skiff of sediment on that top ring there. The weld seam looks to be in pretty good condition all the way around. We do have a little bit of corrosion starting here on that ring, and then on that inner ring. And again, a light skiff of sediment. The door itself appears to be in very good condition. Light skiff of sediment on there as well. The gasket all the way around appears to be in good condition. So continuing around, you can see that uniform corrosion on that base for the wall seam. Here we have a broom that was left in the tank. Handle there. And here we are coming up to our high fill inlet. This is going to be roughly at the 6. Go down, take a look at how much sediment we have in here. We're looking at about a little over a quarter inch. Mainly looks to be like an iron silt sediment. So, really not a whole lot of sediment in here. We'll head on up. High fill here. Coating on this looks to be in excellent condition. Going all the way up to the top. Give you a quick shot of this.
Great shot. Any problems with this?
That's a negative. Coating, supports, everything. All look to be in very good condition. As we start making our way back down it here. Everything's still looking excellent on that. So we'll head around a little more here. And at about the 7 o'clock we have our outlet.
Good job.
Here again looks to be in excellent condition. Can't see that bottom weld seam, but the rest of the riser does appear to be in excellent condition. No problems there. The inside is sustaining a little bit of corrosion, but that's to be expected with that. And again, that Ford wall seam is in corrosion. Around there. Second manway here. At the 9 o'clock. And a layer of cement on top of that. Weld seam around though. Appears to be in very good condition. A little bit of nodding starting on this ring. And there's some more. For itself though. Appears to be in very good condition. As does the gasket. All the way around. Not seeing any issues there. A little bit of sediment on the wall panels. And as we see around here, we have a drain plug at the 11 o'clock.
Copy. Great job.
Everything on that looks to be in excellent condition. Let's get some sediment. Other than that, very good. So that puts us back here at the 12. So we'll start making our way up. Looking at our first weld seam here. We have a light layer of sediment just hanging on that. And as we go around, wall panels and that seam don't appear to be in excellent condition. No coating issues. As we continue around. Still everything looking to be in excellent condition. There's just some texture underneath the coating. There's our I-fill inlet. Still consistent. Getting a little bit of texture underneath the coating there. Not seeing any issues. A little bit of sediment hanging on that weld seam. And it looks very good all the way around, so I'll head on up a little more. The other way. Check out our panels and weld seams again. Looks like we have just a little bit of corrosion starting on this weld seam. You can see it coming up. Just in that one area though. Very minor. This is the panel. Seems here, you can see it's a little bit of staining right in this area. This is above our inlet right here. Gonna just give it a different color. That's just staining. Consistent, a little bit of corrosion right there. And that seam, and a tiny little nodule right above that seam, next to the vertical weld seam. A little bit of sediment on the wall still as we make our way up. Looks like we have some blisters here. Well, you can see those.
Pretty good job.
And they are starting to crack open and start corroding. A couple more here. Another one. Actually, a few more. here. Really, just seem to be around that weld seam, not seeing up or down on the panels. That puts us back here about the 12, so we'll head up a little more. Okay, I'm still looking to be in good condition. Coating cracking there a little bit, starting to corrode. And up a little higher here on this weld seam. You can see a bunch of the coating starting to crack in this area and extending up above us there on that vertical weld seam. And it also continues horizontally here across this weld seam. And then some more on that vertical. Continuing around. The correction continues. Mainly seems to be staying just around the weld seam there. Panels still looking to be in good condition. Getting some more cracks on the vertical weld seam. And as we continue around, below us here, couple more here, pretty much consistent. Above the inlet, just that stain on that wall panel, giving it the darker color. Some more cracking with the coating. Some corrosion starting. Then as you go up the vertical one too, goes up the up panel. Staying consistent. Appears like it just stays a few inches on each side of the weld seam. The panels themselves look to be in good condition. Just a little cracking. Again, as I said, either side of that weld seam, on the horizontal and vertical weld seams. So, we'll head on up a little more. They're consistent on this weld seam, going around the tank, horizontal and vertical. Again, the panels themselves do appear to be in good condition. It seems like all those issues stay on just a few inches on each side of the weld seams. As we head around this weld seam, staying consistent. Steel coating cracking and starting to corrode. A little bit of sediment settling on the weld seam. And again on the vertical weld seam, the cracking of the coating continues. Then on the panels, all looks to be in good condition. Consistent. It's just a bunch of texture underneath the coating. And you can still see the cracking coating. Continuing around. And again on the vertical. Cracking, staying consistent. Around and panels themselves looking to be very good condition. Since we pass the next weld seam, again, you can see very consistent coating cracking, started to corrode both ways in the horizontal and vertical weld seams. More smaller ones on this weld seam. See all these cracks that are starting to corrode all the way around, and also on the vertical on either side of the weld seam. All those little dots, coating failure. Up. But again, a panel still looking to be in good condition. Don't see any issues. I'm taking a look at our next seam. Still staying consistent. You can see all those little spots of corrosion starting. Again on our vertical. See the corrosion continue all the way around that seam. We have a little spot on the panel here, a couple of them. Starting to see a couple of spots on the panels. Mainly just staying on those weld seams. Just a few spots in between on the panels. And looking at another weld seam across here. Still seeing consistent. Lots of coating cracking and starting to corrode. And all the weld seams as we continue up. And then again, as I said, just a couple spots mixed in on the panels here now. As we get closer to the surface. On the panel. A few more as we go a little higher. So we have some beating coming out from above the surface here. Looking above the water line right here. Our overflow is at the 6 o'clock position here.
Great job.
You can see all the delamination starting to happen on the base and on the sides. Looking at probably 50% coating failure.
How much, I'm sorry?
Like 50% delamination and probably 25%. 25-35% uniform surface corrosion. And we have some more on the walls here above the water line. Looking at the roof, you can see the uniform surface corrosion starting by the seams, also some delamination on the seams, uniform surface corrosion on the edge of the beams, delamination around the hatch at the 6 o'clock. That corrosion extends out towards the center. Do have some delamination
on a couple of the panels over there. So we're probably looking at about 10 to 50% corrosion on the roof. And also, we're looking at about 5% of that delamination. Get some shots. Along here above the waterline, you can see starting to delaminate in a couple spots here. Some uniform surface corrosion starting there. Another support ring on the supports itself. We have some corrosion on the ring above us right here. A lot of the bleeding coming down. But also, there's spots of corrosion. You can see there, speckled above us. This is about the 4 o'clock, and some more. As we head back towards 12, we have some bugs kind of stuck to the wall there. Don't have a gasket on the hatch, we'll stick with the screen. Possible entry points for those insects. So, swimming across towards the 9 o'clock. This is where we have our bullet holes, or where the bullet holes were. They've been prepared from the outside. Put some epoxy from the inside. We have one right above the waterline here. Again, these are in the 9 o'clock area. And you'll air on a suit a few more below us. Right there's one. A couple a little down there. And a couple over here. So that concludes our inspections. We'll go ahead and pause, get our epoxy.
Alright, we're coming out right now, just pouring out some of the bullet holes that we've repaired over, so the coating that we put, and the diver's just going to point them out.
Alright, there's the one above the water line, and here's the first one below. A couple bigger ones there, the next two little smaller ones right there, another big one there. And then the final one below us right there. So, got all of them taken care of, coated over, and we'll set ready to go.
Alright, we'll go and stop here and come back on for our next. Alright, we're coming back online. We're getting ready to start our second tank. This is the 100 foot tall, pressed with 30 foot diameter, steel stand pipe. Once again, prior to entering the tank, all equipment divers are disinfected with a minimum 200 parts per million chlorine solution. The access hatch will be again at the 12 o'clock position, 12 to 3, quadrant 1, 3 to 6, quadrant 2. So on and so forth. So at this time, we'll allow the diver to enter the tank. Once he's in the tank, we'll come back on and start our inspection. Alright, we're coming back online, and our diver's going to start his inspection.
Okay, we're right here at the 12 o'clock position. We do have an internal ladder. Looking at our ladder, we have sediment. It looks like iron silt on top of each one. Sticking up probably about 3/8 inch. Yet we do have corrosion, as you can tell on the base of those ladder rungs. That's all corrosion right there. Safety climb on the inside. Can't tell the condition of the base, the bottom floor panels of our tank, but I'm gonna go get a depth reading right now of our sediment. I'm gonna get a little bit of turbidity from holding on to the ladder, but roughly about an inch.
Copy.
Looks like manganese and iron silt. So we're gonna make our way over to our first man way, which is roughly the about 130 position. Got a shot of that or no?
Thank you. Up just a little bit. That's great.
Okay. We have sediment covering the base of that. A little bit on the upper ring. Corrosion around the outer ring. And the inner ring. Can't really tell due to the sediment. A little nodule right there in the exact center. Right here on the outer ring, that is corrosion. On there. And it goes all the way around it. Corrosion probably about 2-3%. Couple nodules on the base panel in here. here. Do you see them?
Yes, we can.
Up there, over there. On the well seam, going down, a little bit of sediment up here, more. Corrosion nozzles right there. On the panel. We'll go in, as you can tell, that floor is completely covered. Make our way over to our inlet outlet, which is at the 5 o'clock position. Looking, from what I can tell, it's getting sucked in a little bit around it. We do have blistering on the riser, erosion on the inner portion, some sediment adhered to it, sediment going all around it. I don't know, it could be a little bit thicker sediment in this area, 2 inches, but can't really tell. It just started up. The wall over there does have a lot of nodules on it. More nodules on the weld seam in that area, more on the panel. Coming up to our second manway, which is at the about 7 o'clock position. Anyway, looking at this manway, a little bit more sediment on the upper ring. A lot of sediment sitting on that inner portion of the manway. A couple nodules in there. A couple nodules on the outer ring where the sediment isn't touching it, but can't really tell too much. Some blistering around the base of the panel. Right down there, coming down. More nodules. And there's nothing else on the bottom. So we'll head up here in a second after we take out our base in here. More nodules on the base of that panel over here. Over here. Staying consistent. All the way on the weld seam, on the panels. Just in between. A little bit of the sediment that I knocked off the ladder in here. So we'll head up. As you can tell, here's the ladder. Second panel, more corrosion present. Blistering and cracking of the coating. Just heavy in that one area. Over here at the about 8 o'clock position on the second panel up. Really heavy nodules and starting to poof out, so there is pitting happening underneath, as well as the about 6 o'clock, and it's going to stay consistent going up probably about 25% of the panels. As you can tell, right in there, that's just actually corrosion coming off just for myself. Staying consistent on the third panel. Once again, just, I don't know, really textured, like, underneath the coating. Not certain why. But as you can tell, it has been consistent all the way up. 25% of the panels do have corrosion. It's almost like an orange peel effect that we do have going on with the coating in here. It is not completely smooth. About 20-25% of the panels does have corrosion present. knock some of that corrosion off, just the larger nodules. Almost like a thinner coating was put on it and that here properly in here. Stay consistent all the way up. Magic tilt, just, I don't know if you can see that.
Yes, we can. We have a lot of bubbles, but yeah.
Okay, let me get a... there a little bit better?
Yes.
Okay. So just stay consistent all the way around the panel, going up. 25% overall. Does have issues. We'll stay next to it over here by the 6 o'clock just so we can kind of see what it looks like. But it's consistent all the way around the tank on every single panel. So there's no need for me to go over and check out those areas because it's all going to look like this. So they are starting to pit in underneath. Like I said, it's not a blistering. It's more of a, like an orange peel, like the coating didn't adhere properly inside the tank. So more on this cracking of the coating on that actual lead seam. There's not actually blistering happening. It's the coating just didn't adhere properly. A little bit, really good pit right in there on that one. Starting to happen. Some more over here. Larger nodules. Couple getting knocked off, just even from our bubbles. All down there, you can see all that.
Yes, we can.
And it's actually kind of just like raining corrosion in here. At the top, our bubbles are knocking it off. It just stays consistent all the way up. So, it's time for a blast and recoat in the tank. All the way. All the way up. Getting close next to our water line, so we're probably about 20 feet from the roof right now. It just stays consistent everywhere. A lot of staining up in this area. So here at our water line, our overflow is way up there, and I don't know how good of a shot we're gonna necessarily get of it. Let me swim over here a little bit. Can you see that?
Yes, I do. What position is that?
Can you see it better now?
No, we just lost the camera.
Oh. How's that?
That's good.
It's about the 10 o'clock. There's some de-alloying present on the back side of it, covering probably about 2% of it. Uniform surface corrosion about 1%. The seam at the base has a little corrosion on it to where it meets the wall panel, but overall the rest of the coating is in good condition. The roof, up where the vent is in the center, does have uniform surface corrosion on that. And on the panels, covering probably about 5% overall, maybe a little bit more, but it's just in the center. Support ring has a little bit of corrosion on that as well, but once you get out a little bit from the center, the panels are in good condition. It's just more towards the center. The coating is a little bit thinner and does have uniform surface corrosion covering it. 5-10%. No de-alloying on the roof. So, and looking at our ladder in here, it did stay consistent with corrosion on every single rung going up, bearing on the mount.
and not steam right there, but we do have corrosion right there. Corrosion at the backside, right in there, and it just stays consistent on each run, probably about 20%, 15, 20% corrosion overall on that. So, at this time, we'll go ahead and stop and come back on for our next tank.
Alright, we're coming back online. We're getting ready to start our third tank. This tank is approximately 90 foot tall, 18 foot diameter. Again, prior to entering the tank, all equipment divers are inspected with a minimum 200 parts per million chlorine solution. Once again, the access hatch will be at the 12 o'clock position. 12 to 3 will be quadrant 1, 3 to 6 quadrant 2, so on and so forth. So at this time, we'll ahead and pause the video. We'll allow the divers to enter the tank. Once it's in the tank, we'll come back online and start our. Go ahead.
Alright. Starting up our survey, or sorry, our inspection down here at the bottom of the tank. I'm at the 12 o'clock position right now with the ladder. Just trying to get my buoyancy correct real quick, gonna swim over. Actually, scratch that on my head down and check out the sediment. Looks to be only about, I'd say around between an eighth and a quarter inch deep. Very fine, silty sediment. Looks like it's got a little bit of a rust color to it. Might have some iron in it, but other than that, doesn't look to be too bad. Very, very fine. I'm going to go ahead and make my way around over to the first manway. Moving around clockwise. Alright, over to the first manway now. It is at roughly the, I would say probably 4 or 5 o'clock, 4:30 or 5.
Not a problem, thank you, Ben.
Starting to float up, just don't want to shoot to the surface.
That's a good shot there.
Oh, great.
And whenever you get a chance again, our camera just went out. Okay, it's back, we're good. Oh, there we go.
Good.
Yeah, that's a great shot.
Alright, copy that. Alright, heading back. Gonna continue around clockwise. Moving along as I'm moving around, I'm looking at the wall. Don't see any signs of the coating blistering or anything. Coating looks to be in very good condition in this area. Right down here at the bottom, no signs of any corrosion or anything like that. Alright, coming over here, we got three of them in a cluster. I got the outlet right here at the bottom. You got a shot of that?
Yep, great shot.
Copy that. Doesn't appear to be any corrosion on the outlet itself.
What position would you say that's in?
Outlet is in approximately the, I would say probably about 10 o'clock position. Same as the second manway right here. You got a picture of that one?
Yes, I do.
Alright, and then right over here, I would say probably at about the 10:30, close to the 11 o'clock position. Sorry, one second. Got this pipe coming up, that is the inlet. Coming up a little bit, got some supports for the inlet, supports, the coating and everything, looks like it's in very good condition, no signs of any cracking or blistering. A little bit of sediment settled here on the top, but a little bit of minor staining, other than that, looks to be in very good condition. And I'm going to do a little bit of a lap around the pipe here. Coating on the inlet itself looks to be in very good condition. Coming to the next set of supports. Coating still appears to be in very good condition. A little bit of sediment settled up on the top. No sign of any corrosion. No cracking or blistering in the coating. Got a little bit of heavy staining as we come up towards the top of it. Looks like it rubs off a little bit.
to some heavy staining. Other than that, no signs of any cracking or anything. Coating on this other support looks to be in very good condition as well. Alright, coming to the top of the inlet. Got a good picture there.
Keep back, wait just a little more. That's good.
Okay. On the inside of the inlet, looks like we have about 100% uniform surface corrosion. On the outer edge, looks like it's still in very good condition. Inlet overall, very, very good condition. Alright, back at the 12 o'clock position now. Looking at the wall here, just going to kind of gradually go around on my way up. So far, I'm headed back counterclockwise now, so I'm going to get my umbilical bunched up. Sorry, I'm letting some more air out of my suit. So I don't just shoot up on my way.
Copy that. While you're at the ladder, can you just give us a quick shot of that?
Yeah, absolutely. How's that?
That's good. Actually, back away just a little more. I'm sorry. That's good.
Okay. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and head around counterclockwise now, on my way up. Looking at the walls. Got a little bit of staining, I think, right in here. Oops, sorry, there's a little sediment there. Little bit of sediment that's still on the walls, some minor staining. Other than that, no sign of any blistering or cracking on the coating of the walls. Walls are in very good condition so far. Continuing around counterclockwise. Still the same thing. A little bit of sediment settled on the walls. It looks like staining, but it comes right up by touches, so it's just some sediment that settled there. Other than that, no signs of any cracking, blistering, corrosion on the walls. So far, walls are in very good condition. All the seams as well for the panels seem to be in very good condition. Might have a little bit, nope, sorry, that's a little bit of sediment there as well. So far, no noduling or any sort of corrosion to speak of on the walls. Back to the ladder, the 12 o'clock position. Supports for the ladder look to be in great condition as well. Check out, oops. Sure.
Yes.
Okay, thought the camera went out. Okay, going up the ladder a little bit. Gonna do another lap going back around clockwise this time as I'm on my way up. Going around, wall still appears to be in very good condition. No signs of any cracking or blistering. No signs of any corrosion or noduling starting. Coating on the wall looks to be in excellent condition all the way around aside for some minor sediment. But they've got a little bit of a water line here, part of the way up. That's probably where the sediment looks like it ends. Wall appears to be pretty clean. On up after that. A little bit of sediment settled out right here. Continuing around clockwise, other than that. Got some more sediment up on the walls here. No sign of any cracking, noduling, or corrosion or anything. No signs of any blistering in the coating. Coating appears to be in excellent condition. Back at the ladder. I'm gonna head up a little bit more. Look at the ladder. The ladder still appears to be in excellent condition as well. No signs of any corrosion. A little bit of corrosion maybe coming through on a couple of rungs where the weld seam meets the side braces. Other than that, ladder's in very good condition. Make another lap around the wall. Going counterclockwise again this time. Going around, you can see that the wall is still in very good condition. No signs of any cracking or blistering. Very little sediment to speak of on the wall in this area. Got another wall seam right here going around. Still looks to be in very good condition. Sorry, a little bit of air out of my suit. Okay. And continuing around. Again, walls are in very good condition. No signs of any cracking or blistering in the coating. This looks like a little bit of dripping when they might have put it on. Might have a little bit of blistering in this area. 1 second. Looks like it might have a little bit of blistering in the coating right here. A little bit of corrosion coming through. It's a very small area right in here. Other than that, it looks like mostly staining. Or it could be a possible sediment again. Got a little bit more corrosion coming through in this area as I've come up a little bit. Actually, it looks like it got a pretty uniform ring around this weld seam that has some decent corrosion or staining on it. Other than that, the wall appears to be in very good condition. No signs of any cracking in the coating. Doesn't look like there's any blistering or corrosion or nothing starting anywhere else. The wall still appears to be in very good condition. Coming back to the ladder, back at the 12 o'clock position. Just got some sediment settled on some of the rungs here. Coming up a little bit. Still no signs of any cracking or blistering to speak of in the coating. Still looks to be in very good condition. I'm going to go ahead and make another lap around going clockwise this time. Coating still appears to be in very good condition. Got a couple little spots here and there where a little bit might have flaked off. No sign of any corrosion in that area. A little bit of minor staining here and there in the coating. Other than that, no signs of any major blistering or cracking. No signs of any corrosion in this area. Coating itself and the wall both appear to be in very good condition still. A little bit of a line right here. Looks like it might have been a scratch or something where the coating was applied. Scratch underneath. Where the coating flaked off a little bit. Sorry, I just got my face to gun fog. Actually, that looks like that might just be some staining. It rubs off pretty easily. Doesn't look like there's any corrosion at all in this area. Looks like just a little bit of heavy staining very intermittently. Just kind of spot throughout. Yep, just a little bit of staining, no cracking or noduling any kind of corrosion on the wall. So continue clockwise, but about the same thing all the way around. No signs of any cracking, no corrosion or blistering. Coating looks to be in very good condition other than a little bit of staining. Very intermittent here and there. And that's about it. Coating still appears to be in very good condition. Got another seam here. Still the same thing. Stand by. Got a line of staining that appears to be going down, up and down vertically on the side of the wall. Doesn't appear to be corrosion or anything. Other than that, coating looks like it's in good shape. I can't tell if this is blistering right here. You got a shot of this in the area?
Yes, we do. Is that just some texture underneath the coating?
Yeah, that's what it looks like. I just can't really tell. It looks like it's texture underneath. If it is blistering, nothing's broken or anything yet or cracked through. There's no signs of any corrosion. I think it is just some texture underneath the coating. Coating still looks to be in very good condition.
Copy.
All right, going to go ahead and continue on up. A few runs looking at the ladder. Ladder still, of course, in very good condition. Got the sediment settling on the rungs, as well as the supports connecting the ladder to the wall. All the seams and the coating on the ladder itself, as well as the ladder itself, look to be in very good condition still. I'm going to make another lap going back around counterclockwise, looking at the wall. A little bit of sediment right there. Looking around as I'm moving counterclockwise, still seeing the same thing all the way around. A little bit of intermittent staining here and there. No signs of any cracking in the coating. No signs of any blistering or any kind of corrosion going on. So far, until I get to this area, looks like I might have a little bit of noggle starting here. Yeah, you got a picture of that?
Yes, I do. We have a great shot.
Copy that. A little bit of noggle starting right there. Looks like it's coming through the coating. Other than that, everything appears to be just some staining. Wall itself, still no signs of any cracking in the coating. No blistering, no other signs of any corrosion.
still looks to be in very good condition, other than some heavy staining intermittently throughout. Same with on the weld seam right here. Everything still appears to be in very good condition. Again, as we're moving along, you're still seeing a bunch of intermittent staining, heavier in some parts than it is in others. No signs of any cracking, still no signs of any blistering. Just a couple spots of corrosion that we saw further back there. Other than that, coating on the wall itself appeared to be in very good condition. A little bit more of the texturing we saw earlier coming through right here. Nothing to worry about. Coat is still in great condition in that area. And we're back up on surface. Come out to the center a little bit, get a shot of the roof. The roof itself looks to be in very good condition. No signs of any corrosion on the roof itself. Seems to be in very good condition. Got a good shot of the vent right there.
Yes.
A little bit of corrosion starting around the edge of the vent. You see a little bit of stain running down from that. Other than that, vent still appears to be in very good condition, as well as the roof. Got some corrosion starting at the lip. I'm sorry, at the joint where the roof meets the wall. I'm trying to get over to it right now. Got a little bit of staining running down from that. Just looks like it might be a little bit of uniform surface corrosion right up by the joint. And it's kind of intermittent going all the way around. It appears a little bit of staining here and there. And judging from right here, it looks like that might have been what caused some of the staining on the wall as we go down. I don't know if you have a picture of this right here.
Yes, I do.
Okay, got a little bit of staining right above that. That might have been what caused that staining. Then we got the overflow pipe right here. I am at roughly the 9 o'clock position. Overflow pipe has a bit of staining on the top of it. Joint itself, where it goes in the wall, a little bit of heavy staining. Joint itself and the weld seam appear to be in very good condition. Overall condition of the pipe seems to be very good. No signs of any cracking in the coating. No signs of any corrosion, just some heavy staining right there after it comes out of the wall. Coming to the back side of the overflow. I don't know if I can get the camera in. Can you see this corrosion right here on the back of it?
Yes, we can.
Okay. That looks to be the only sign of any corrosion on the overflow itself. That is a good amount back there. It's got quite a bit of corrosion coming through. The coating is blistered and cracked all the way through in that small little area. I'd say the area itself is probably about a good 6 to 8 inches long. Roughly 2 to 3 inches wide. That's the only spot where there's any corrosion on the overflow itself. Inside the pipe looks to be in pretty good condition. Got some sediment settled right there inside the lip. You can see in some heavy staining. Looks like you got a little bit of blistering and cracking in the coating where you got some corrosion coming through on the inside of the overflow. Other than that, overflow itself appears to be in very good condition. Taking another quick look at the roof.
Can you just give us a quick overall of that overflow?
Yeah, absolutely. How's that?
Of the overflow?
Of the overflow, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I thought you said quick overall of the roof.
That's good right there.
Okay, you want one underneath as well?
Yep, that's good.
Alright, and I think that pretty much completes it.
All right, you're rolling.
All right, we're coming on. We're getting ready to start our second day for the City of Peabody, Missouri. Today, we're going to be doing two steel on-grade tanks. First one is approximately 56 foot high, 55 foot diameter. Steel on-grade, as always, all equipment divers are disinfected with a minimum 200 parts per million chlorine solution. The next set, again, will be at the 12 o'clock position, 12 to 3, quadrant 1, 3 to 6, quadrant 2, so on and so forth. This time, we'll go ahead and pause the video, allow the diver to enter the tank. Once he's in the tank and working, we'll come back online and start our inspection.
All right, you're rolling.
Okay, we're coming on right now for our inspection. Just take some shots of the roof right here. You can see a little bit of bleeding and corrosion along the edges of our supports on the roof and a little bit along a couple of the seams on the panels. The rest of the panels themselves do appear to be in excellent condition, though. Not seeing any other issues. So really, overall, on the roof, we're maybe looking at 1% corrosion. And that's, again, just on the seams and on the edges of the beams, the support beams in the tank. So we'll start here at the 12 o'clock. Was no internal ladder in the tank, so we had to stick our own in here. And you can see the heavy staining line, probably where they, you guys normally keep your water level. Above that line, you can see the big color difference. The nice bright white above, and then the heavier staining dark reddish color on the side. We have these cutouts in the side of the tank right here. This is actually the overflow in the tank, and it extends from basically the 12 o'clock to probably almost the 5 o'clock. Water just reaches that level and then flows out those screens. The screens themselves do appear to be in good condition. They do have some debris blocking some of the mesh, but overall, good condition. So we'll just head to the wall here, start making our way down, and see what else we have. Leaving surface.
Copy that.
And again, right here, you can see the staining on the wall. And then as we get down, getting less of the staining, which you've seen on the weld seam there. Wall panel, excellent condition. So far, appears like we have some texture underneath the coating. Almost looks like blistering, but it's actually just a texture underneath that was coated over. So the wall panel is still looking to be in very good condition. Just a little bit of staining on the wall. You can see that sediment on there. Very light sediment. You can see like a manganese iron silt type sediment hanging on the wall. Which will kind of hang away from the wall a little bit so we don't disturb the sediment that's on there. Just like a caulking or something hanging on the wall right there. Again, remember that texture underneath the coating as we keep making our way down. Weld seams and wall panels still looking to be in very good condition. And we're coming closer to the floor, but one more panel. And make sure we're still right below the ashes hatch here. Again, you can see just even getting close to the wall, it's going to disturb that sediment on there, but we'll get the best looks we can. Continue down. Still looking to be in very good condition. Not seeing any issues. Everything looking very good. And here we are. Close to the floor. It appears that we have roughly about a half an inch of what appears to be iron silt, possibly a little bit of manganese mixed in. Again, roughly about a half an inch. So we'll continue on clockwise here and see what else we have on the tank. We're not going to get very good look at the floor because there is that constant coating, constant layer of sediment, across the whole bottom of the tank. As you can see across there. Oh, that's just a lot of sediment. I thought maybe we'd pass over a piece of plumbing, but we'll just continue around the tank here. See what else we come across.
wall seam. Looks to be in excellent condition. Not seeing any issues there. Again, looking at our wall. Not seeing any issues. The panels look to be in very good condition. And that layer of sediment on there. Try and hang back a little bit. Whoop the wall a little bit. See what it looks like. Still staying consistent. Looks to be in very good condition. Not seeing any signs of cracking or blistering. Well, seems the same. Not seeing any coating issues. Just that light layer of sediment. As we continue up, still staying consistent. Really looking to be in very good condition. Sediment gets a little lighter. As we get higher, we get a little more staining as we get closer to the surface. But still, wall panels and wall seams looking to be in excellent condition. As we continue up, there we have some insects floating. Probably coming in through the vent screen or the hatch. Here we are.
Hey Tom, sorry to interrupt you. Did you see the manway while you were down at the bottom?
It's going to be over, I don't know if there's off the pullback, seeing one. Over at about the 11:55, so it's going to be ahead of us yet.
Oh, I copy that. My bad. Sorry, go ahead.
Not a problem. And again, just want to point out, we do have some insects getting into the tank. You can see here, we've seen a couple floating just before we got to the surface. Another one here. Possibly need it. And again, above us on the light, they really stand out. Possibly could use a gasket on the hatch or a smaller mesh on our vent or overflow screens. Again, the roof of this area looks to be in good condition. Again, just that little bit of corrosion on the edges of the beams and a little bit on some of the seams of the panels. But the panels themselves still looking to be in excellent condition. So we'll head on down. And as we make our way down, still looking very consistent. Have your stain up higher here. And then as we continue down, turns into sediment hanging on the wall. But again, our wall panels are going to be in very good condition. Looks like we have just a small nodule right in front of us there. First one I've seen so far. And continuing down, right now we're heading down in a 6 o'clock area. And again, everything's still looking very consistent. Not seeing any coating issues. Weld seams and panels still very good condition. Just that sediment hanging on the walls. Everything's still looking to be in good condition.
very uniform. Still not seeing any issues. A little bit heavier fading in spots. Feels really like we have a couple nodules here again in this area. There and a couple more over here. Pretty small nodules, not even the size of a dime. And here we are coming back to the floor. And our floor and wall seam looks to be in good condition. Looks like we have that iron silt layer of sediment still in here. Looks to be about 3/4 of an inch in this area. This really hasn't changed a whole lot from the front to the back of the tank. Again, this is roughly the 6 o'clock position. And heading out to the center here a little more. Kind of a lighter layer. Probably only about a 1/4 inch out here. And again, really not gonna see a whole lot going on with the floor. We do have a pad eye right in the very center of the tank. It's probably the only thing we're gonna be able to distinguish on the floor. And that looks to be in good condition, no corrosion or anything there. So that was the center of the tank. Kinda maybe head down right there at the center. Try and get a good look how deep it is right there. Consistent as well, roughly about 1/2 inch of that iron silt sediment. So head back out to the wall, continuing around. Roughly 7:30. Looking at a wall. Again, just a light layer of sediment. The iron silt and manganese. Very easy to disrupt. So we'll just kind of hang back again. But again, not seeing any coating issues. Floor and wall seam appears to be in good condition. Coming up to about the 9 o'clock. Go ahead and head up the wall in this area again. See if you have any changes. Should be staying consistent. A little nodule right there on the wall. So far haven't even seen, not even nowhere near to 1% of corrosion in this tank. Really, it's actually looking to be in very good condition. Just a few small nodules so far. And again, our wall looking to be in very good condition. Just that layer of sediment. A little bit coming off the wall right there. And as we get higher, get less sediment, more staining. Cody's still looking to be excellent condition. Not seeing any issues. And the can very consistent. Again, have your staining up higher as we get closer to the water line. Still not seeing any issues. A little bit of bleeding coming down from above the waterline, so that darker staining is. Right there. Bleeding coming down from the roof and wall seam. Again, in this area, a little bit of corrosion on some of the panels. And again, on the supports, on the edges. Again, on the wall, we have some insects adhered to the wall above the water line. Everything else, though, looking to be in good condition. So just make our way back down. Again, looking to be in excellent condition. Any coating issues. Well, that looks like the coating ran a little bit down that seam when they applied it. Getting into more sediment. As we head down, we have some texture underneath the coating. Condition. Not seeing any problems. Just that layer of sediment on the wall. Are they still very good condition? Problems. So keep on heading down. Everything's still very good condition. Well teams, well panels. Another small nodule right in front of us there. Right there. Very scattered and small. Below us, there. Right below us here at what we call the 11:30, we have our inlet outlet. Okay. Going for a closer look. Has a recessed basin around it with a bunch of heavier material, nodulin, and some metal fragments settled in there. The basin does have some nodulin in it, like you see just below us right there. Right around it here, you can see some of these larger flakes that have blown out inside. We do have a lot of sediment staining, but overall looks to be in good condition.
riser itself. You can see just that stain on there, as well as on the outside. We have some nodules around this seam and towards the base. Probably looking at about 5% corrosion. Other than that, looks to be in good condition. The weld seam round has some sediment around there from what is exposed. All looks to be in good condition. And again, just some heavier fragments that have settled out around the inlet here. And just past that, on the wall, we have our manway, roughly the 1155. Let me know we gotta get you out of that.
Look up just a little bit. Perfect picture.
Okay. We do have a bigger nodule to the right of the manway, right there. Has some minor pitting below that. Also, some little nodules along this weld seam. Going around the manway, you can see on the bottom edge of the weld seam. And also some nodules on the door panel itself. From what I can see, the gasket appears to be in good condition. We do have some staining on the door and some sediment on that inner ring there. The rest of the inner ring, though, appears to be in good condition. Not seeing any major issues with that. We're probably looking at 3% corrosion on the manway overall. And then outer weld seam looks to be in good condition. Again, some nodules up there around that as well, but nothing of really major concern. So we'll head on up. Take a look at our wall as we head up. Again, not seeing any issues. Sediment down towards the bottom. As we head up, probably gotta find just the stain. And in between the two, really nothing. There's a section where a little bit on the weld seams, and other than that, a little bit of texture under the coating. Still looking to be in very good condition. All looking to be in very good condition as we continue up. Nice white coating. A little bit of sediment on the weld seam. Still looking to be in very good condition. Some more texture underneath with some sediment in this area. Again, all looking to be in very good condition. Next weld seam again, very good condition. Has our weld panel. Wall panels. Now we're getting into just the staining on the wall. As we continue up, the heavier staining with some texture again under the coating. Okay, some stray welds. Got some staining on them. And some heavier staining. As we continue up, the waterline and the heaviest thing again right here at the waterline. So that should conclude this tank. Go ahead and pause the video and come back online for our next tank.
You're on.
All right, we're getting ready to do our last tank. This tank again is approximately 56 foot high. This one is the smaller of the two tanks, approximately 25 foot diameter, steel on grade tank. As always, all equipment divers are disinfected with the minimum 200 parts marine chlorine solution before entering the tank. Again, the access has to be at the 12 o'clock position, 12 to 3, quadrant 1, 3 to 6, quadrant 2, so on and so forth. So again, we'll go ahead and pause the video, allow the diver to enter the tank, get situated. Once he's in the tank, we'll come back on and start doing our inspection.
You're rolling.
All right, we're we're coming on to do our final tank. Just want to point out this upper edge of the angle iron. You can see all that uniform surface corrosion.
And it goes all the way around the tank on that piece of angle iron. We also have some corrosion starting on the seams of the panels and again on the supports. We're looking at about 3% corrosion on the roof. Mainly just uniform surface corrosion. No really major issues. Also, we have our support ring at the top here.
Just want to point that out. We have some corrosion on the inside back there. Nothing serious. A little bit of delamination of the coating in a couple spots. And then just a bunch of heavier staining above the water line, like we've seen in the last tank. Then some heavier areas where bleeding has come down from above.
So, quick look towards the center here.
See again, just more of the uniform surface corrosion starting on the support going across,
and then on the seams themselves, you can see a little bit of corrosion starting. So, let's get around our ladder here. Start making our way down.
Copy that. Copy.
Just below the waterline, we have some heavier sediment staining on the wall panel. You can see that right there. And then as we start making our way down, our wall panels look to be in very good condition. Again, some sediment staining on the panels, but seen other issues. Still looks good. You can see the unevenness after the previous coating, the paint and stuff that was in the metal before, but the new coating looks to be in very good condition. As we keep heading down, our weld seams as well could be in very good condition. Not seeing any problems. You see there, very light sediment on the walls. We'll just go ahead and stay back from the walls again as we head down. But still looking at the panels. Still looking to be in very good condition. Not seeing any problems. Small nodule right there in front of us. Sediment getting a little heavier on the walls as we continue down. But the panel still looking to be in very good condition. Still no promise to note. Looks like something had fallen from above and made a line down the wall panel as it fell down. And again, our wall panels and weld seams looking to be in very good condition. Coming up to the floor now. Small nodule right there at the Florida wall seam. Looks like we have again. Try and get down closer. We do have about an inch and a half of iron silt sediment in this tank. So again, we're not going to get any good shots to the floor. Here's our center pad eye. Has a little bit of corrosion on that. Overall condition. It's the only thing we're going to be able to really note with the floor. So we'll head back to the wall. Get a good bearing where I'm at here. We have our inlet outlet over here,
roughly the 3 to 3:30 position. Let me know if I get a shot of that.
Great picture, thank you.
Okay. There's about a 3 foot riser on the inlet outlet. You can see the floor is exposed right around it. A couple small nodules around that base pad and weld seam. Now we do have some nodules down here on the connection for the riser. And a couple more on the backside there. Some staining on the riser. There's no major issues. We're looking at maybe 2 to 3% corrosion. Some more staining on the inside. And you can see a staining on the top edge of the riser here. Really no issues with that. Just that little bit of corrosion down at the base pad and then at the connection where the riser meets. Again, looking at our wall. Here's 3 o'clock area. So we got a little scratch right above the inlet here. It's starting to corrode there a little bit. But looking around, not seeing any other issues. We'll go ahead and hit up the wall in the 3 o'clock area right here. There we have some stray welds with sediment sitting on them, but no other issues. A little heavier staining right above the inlet outlet right here. So that's all that material is right there, is just a staining from the water coming in. And again, here's some stray welds which have some sediment on them. Does not have, appear to have any other issues. So we'll head on up. I'm looking back and forth here. And a little heavier staining right above the inlet. And possibly a little bit of corrosion. Some of these spots are staining, but some of them are also little nodules in there. That's right above the inlet. Probably just from the water moving up and down. Causing a little bit of issue with the coating in this area. It just appears to be this 3 foot span right above the inlet. All of it seems to be contained right between there. But it does continue up the wall panel. You continue up. Just these little, all these little spots. So overall, we're probably looking at 3 to 5% of the panel on the wall. But again, just seems to be staying right above the inlet outlet. So far, I'm kind of trailing off as we get closer to the surface. A little bit more here towards the 4 o'clock, another bigger area. Some corrosion starting. Doesn't appear to be any pitting, but corrosion is starting to show through. And extending out towards 4:30 there a little bit. So the panels looking to be in good condition though. But it is continuing up. In the 4 o'clock. As we get closer to the surface. And the trail's off. A little bit more here, but not as concentrated. It was lower. And then some more bleeding. And then heavier staining on the walls. Up closer to the water line. And that's actually closer to the 5 o'clock area. We have our overflow. Out of that.
Copy that. Good picture. Thank you.
Okay, we do have a little bit of
corrosion starting on the underside. We overflow and a little bit on the top edge of the flare out up there. Maybe looking at 2% corrosion overall on that. But again, on our support ring here, you can see the uniform surface corrosion on the underside, spinning around. And then again on that upper angle iron, where the roof and roof seam meet, you can see the uniform surface corrosion continuing on that all the way around the tank. And again on our roof, on our panel seams, you can see some corrosion starting. And again on our supports,
like we have discussed earlier.
So we'll head down here, 6 o'clock area. See what we have. And a couple of those little spots, corrosions we had down. A few more. Rest of the wall so far looking good. A little bit of sediment on those stray welds. Mixed in with that sediment. Probably looking at a little higher percent, maybe up to 10% corrosion on the panels. You can see some more of those bigger nodules mixed in with the sediment there. Coming through those darker spots. And there's a little bit smaller ones mixed in back here. As we keep heading down, again, it doesn't appear to be pitting in. Corrosion just appears to be starting. Oh, it's going to be in too bad a condition. Still small specks of that corrosion mixed in with that sediment. Sediment getting a little heavier as we get closer to the bottom. You can see a few of those little bigger nodules, darker spots sticking out. And coming up to the bottom, you have some nodules on that Florida wall seam. Scattered out. Get down a little bit here. See if we can get depth on the sediment. Back at 6 o'clock. Again, we're looking at still a consistent inch and a half. Back here at the 6, so staying pretty consistent. So head over towards the 9. Couple bigger nodules right here on the wall towards the 9 o'clock, and right here at about the 10:30, we have our manway.
Just a little bit. Great picture, thank you.
Okay.
Sorry, you said that was 10 o'clock position.
Yeah, 10:30.
Copy, thank you.
You can see the sediment kind of built up there. That's basically what we're looking at on the floor as well. About an inch and a half. Do have a little bit of corrosion in the center there. Nothing on the test spigot on the outside. And it's corroding on the inside. You can see along the weld seam here, all these little nodules starting to show through all the way around that outer weld seam. And also on the inside there, where the gasket is, you can see the nodules starting. And a couple stray ones in the door. We're probably looking at about 3-5% corrosion on the manway. So we'll go ahead and head up the wall in this area. See what we got.
brush away a little bit of the sediment. So you can get a good look at the wall. These nodules continuing in this area as well. Again, not appear to be pitting into the metal, so they're just starting. But they are getting pretty concentrated in areas. As you can see, as we start heading up, continuing up. So definitely something you're going to want to keep an eye on and monitor, see, check the progression of it, so it doesn't take off on you. Again, you can see them as we continue up the wall. As well, a little bit behind us, towards 9 o'clock, you can see that whole area. That's all the corrosion. Just like in front of us here. Been looking towards the 12. Not really seeing any issues. So continuing up. You can see the corrosion continuing in this area, right in front of us. And back a little bit here, towards the 9. Anyway, as we get higher on the walls, back and forth here, Sandy, from the 11, again back to the 9, back and forth up the wall. Continuing as we keep making our way up, getting to see a little bit more staining on the wall as we make our way up. We'll see, you can see the corrosion continuing. Probably even looking at a little higher percent, maybe a 15-20% corrosion on the wall panels. And it kind of trails off. Maybe closer to the surface, the staining gets a little more. You still can't see these little bigger, darker spots mixed in there. So the corrosion continuing up to the surface. And then above the waterline, you see the darker staining. Above there, the surface corrosion starting on the underside of that support ring, as well as on that upper angle iron, the wall and roof meet up, and I'll be around the tank. So, at this time, that'll conclude this tank. On behalf of Inland Potable Services, we'd like to thank you for using our company, and hopefully you do again in the future.
Warning, this is a video record for the City of Peabody, conducted by Inland Potable Services. Today and tomorrow we will be inspecting 5 tanks. First of the 5 is going to be a 236,000 gallon steel on-grade standpipe. Before entering the tank, the diver and equipment are going to be disinfected with a minimum of 200 parts per million chlorine solution. While the diver's inside the tank, he's going to use clock references to reference his position in the tank. 12 to 3 is quadrant 1, 3 to 6 is quadrant 2, so on and so forth. This way we know where the diver is. Diver's in there, he's going to tell us depth of the sediment and also note any problems. This time we'll go ahead and pause, allow the diver to enter the tank. Once he's in the tank, we'll come back on to start today's activities. Alright, we're coming on right now. The diver's inside the tank. He's going to go through the inspection right now.
Alright, we're here at the 12 o'clock position. Taking a look at the wall. Do have a light sift of sediment on the wall, as you can see right there. Rest of the coating condition appears to be in good condition. As we get towards the foot of the wall seam, I'm going to hang up a little bit here so we don't disturb the sediment. We can see a little bit of corrosion starting by the floor of the wall seam. A couple of nodules here on the wall panel itself. And then again up a little higher. Everything looking to be very good condition. Just a slight sniff of staining. And again, by the floor wall seam, you can see a little bit of corrosion noduling starting. And here we are at the 3 o'clock.
Got a good shot.
We have our first man weight.
Yeah, have a great shot.
Okay, we have a slight skiff of sediment on the top ring there. The weld seam looks to be in pretty good condition all the way around. We have a little bit of corrosion starting here on that ring and then on that inner ring. Again, a light skiff of sediment. The door itself appears to be in very good condition. Light skiff of sediment on there as well. The gasket all the way around appears to be in good condition. So continuing around, you can see that uniform corrosion on that base floor wall seam. Here we have a broom that was left in the tank. Handle there. And here we are coming up to our high fill inlet. This is going to be roughly at the 6. We'll go down and take a look at how much sediment we have in here. We're looking at about a quarter inch. Mainly looks to be like an iron silt sediment. So, really not a whole lot of sediment in here. Head on up. High fill here. Coating on this looks to be in excellent condition. Going all the way up to the top. Give you a quick shot of this.
Great shot. Any problems with this?
That's a negative. Coating, supports, everything. All look to be in very good condition. As we start making our way back down in here. Everything's still looking excellent on that. So we'll head around a little more here. And at about 7 o'clock, we have our outlet.
Good job.
The outlet here, again, looks to be in excellent condition. Can't see that bottom weld seam. But the rest of the riser does appear to be in excellent condition. No problems there. The inside has some staining and a little bit of corrosion, but that's to be expected with that. And again, that Florida wall seam is in corrosion. Around there. Second manway here. The 9 o'clock. And a layer of cement on the top of that. Weld seam around though, appears to be in very good condition. A little bit of noduling starting on this ring. And there's some more. Door itself though, appears to be in very good condition. As does the gasket all the way around. Not seeing any issues there. A little bit of sediment on the wall panels. As we stay around here, we have a drain plug at 11 o'clock.
Copy. Great job.
Everything on that looks to be in excellent condition. Let's get some sediment. Other than that, very good. That puts us back here at the 12. So we'll start making our way up. Looking at our first weld seam here. We have a layer of sediment just hanging on that. As we go around, wall panels and that seam to appear to be in excellent condition. No coating issues. As we continue around, still everything looking to be in excellent condition. Just some texture underneath the coating. Here's our I-fill inlet. And continuing around, everything's still consistent. Getting a little bit of texture underneath the coating there. Let's see. Any issues? A little bit of sediment hanging on that weld seam. And it looks very good all around, so I'll head on up a little more. And then swim back the other way. Check out our panels and weld seams again. Looks like we have just a little bit of corrosion starting on this weld seam. With a little bit of bleeding you can see coming up. Just in that one area though, very minor. The rest of the panels and seams here, you can see it's a little bit of staining right in this area. This is above our inlet right here. Gonna just give it a different color. That's just staining. And everything's still pretty consistent. A little bit of corrosion right there. That seam and a tiny little nodule right above that seam next to the vertical weld seam. But sitting on the wall still as we make our way up. Looks like we have some blisters here. I don't know how well you can see those.
Pretty good job.
And they are starting to crack open and start corroding. A couple more here. Another one. Actually, a few more. Here. Really just seem to be around that weld seam, not seeing up or down on the panels. That puts us back here about the 12, so we'll head up a little more. Weld panel's still looking to be in good condition. Coating cracking there a little bit, starting to corrode. And up a little higher here on this weld seam. You can see a bunch of the coating starting to crack in this area. And extending up above us there on that vertical weld seam. And it also continues horizontally here. Across this weld seam, and some more on that vertical, continuing around, the cracking continues, mainly seems to be staying just around the weld seam there. And looking to be in good condition. Getting some more cracks in the vertical. Well, it seems. And as we continue around, below us here. Consistent. All the way around. And then again, this is where the above the inlet, just that stain on that wall panel. Doing it the darker color. Some more cracking with the coating. Some corrosion starting. Then as you go the vertical and tube, goes up the up panel. Consistent. Appears like it just stays a few inches on each side of the weld seam. The panels themselves look to be in good condition. Just a little cracking. Again, as I said, either side of that weld seam, on the horizontal and vertical weld seams. So, we'll head on up a little more. Consistent again on this weld seam, going around the tank, horizontal and vertical. Again, the panels themselves do appear to be in good condition. It seems like all those issues stay on just a few inches on each side of the weld seams. As we head around this weld seam, staying consistent. Steel coating cracking and starting to corrode. A little bit of sediment settling on the weld seam. And again on the vertical weld seam, the cracking of the coating continues. Then on the panels, all looks to be in good condition. Consistent. It's just a bunch of texture underneath the coating. And you can still see the cracking coating. Continuing around. And again on the vertical. Cracking, being consistent around the tank. All these spots. So we'll head on up a little more. Again, the panels themselves looking to be in very good condition. Then as we pass the next weld seam, again, you can see. Very consistent. The coating cracking. Starting to corrode both ways. Horizontal and vertical weld seams. Still remaining consistent, just a lot more smaller ones. On this weld seam, see all these little cracks that are starting to corrode. All the way around, and also on the vertical, on either side of the weld seam, those little dots, coating failure, and it continues up. But again, our panel still looking to be in good condition.
taking a look at our next seam. Still staying consistent. See all those little spots of corrosion starting. Bigger area right here. Starting to corrode. Again, our vertical. Seam. We have a little spot on the panel here, a couple of them. Small ones, a couple more. That's it right there. So starting to see a couple of spots on the panels. Mainly just staying. Some of those well seams. Just a few spots in between on the panels. Looking at another well seam across here. Still staying consistent. All those spots of coating cracking and starting to corrode. And all the weld seams as we continue up. And then again, as I said, just a couple spots mixed in on the panels here now. As we get closer to the surface. Standing still on the walls. Spots on the panel. A few more. As we go a little higher. Looks like we have some beading coming out from above the surface here. Above the water line right here. Our overflow is at the 6 o'clock position here.
Great shot.
You can see all the delamination starting to happen on the base and on the sides. Looking at probably 50% coating failure.
How much, I'm sorry?
Like 50% delamination and probably 25%. 25 to 35% uniform surface corrosion.
Copy that.
And we have some more on the walls here above the water line. Looking at the roof, you can see the uniform surface corrosion starting by the seams, also some delamination on the seams. Uniform surface corrosion on the edge of the beams. Delamination around the hatch at the 6 o'clock. That corrosion extends out towards the center. Do have some delamination on a couple of panels over there. So we're probably looking at about 10 to 50% corrosion on the roof. Also, we're looking at about 5% of that delamination. Get some shots. Well, here above the waterline, see, starting to delaminate in a couple spots here. Some uniform surface corrosion starting. There. Another support ring on the supports itself. We have some corrosion on the ring. Folks right here, a lot of the bleeding coming down. But also, there's spots of corrosion. You can see there, speckled above us. And this is at about the 4 o'clock. And some more. As we head back towards 12, we do have some bugs kind of stuck to the wall there. Don't have a gasket on the hatch. We'll stick with the screen. Possible entry points for those insects. So, swim across towards the 9 o'clock. That's where we have our bullet holes. Or, where the bullet holes were. They've been repaired from the outside. We're going to put some epoxy from the inside. We have one right above the waterline here. Again, these are in the 9 o'clock area.
fuel air on my suit. A few more below us.
There's one. A couple. Another one down there. And a couple over here. So, that concludes our inspections. We'll go ahead and pause. Get our epoxy.
Alright, we're coming out right now. Just pouring out some of the bullet holes that we prepared over. So, the coating that we put. And the diver's just going to point them out.
Alright, there's the one above the water line. And here's the first one. Below. Bigger ones there. Then there's two little smaller ones. Right there. Another big one there. And then the final one below us right there. So, got all of them taken care of, coated over, and we'll set ready to go.
Alright, we'll go and stop here and come back on for next. Alright, we're coming back online. We're getting ready to start our second tank. This is the 100 foot tall, approximately 30 foot diameter, steel standpipe. Once again, prior to entering the tank, likely the divers are disinfected with a minimum 200 parts per million chlorine solution. The access hatch will be again at the 12 o'clock position, 12 to 3, quadrant 1, 3 to 6, quadrant 2. So on and so forth. So at this time, we'll allow the diver to enter the tank. Once he's in the tank, we'll come back on and start our inspection. All right, we're coming back online, and our diver's going to start his inspection.
Okay, we're right here at the 12 o'clock position. We do have an internal ladder. Looking at our ladder, we have sediment. It looks like iron silt on top of each one. Up probably about 3/8 inch. Yet we do have corrosion, as you can tell on the base of those ladder rungs. That's all corrosion right there. Safety climb on the inside. Can't tell the condition of the base, the bottom floor panels of our tank, but I'm gonna go get a depth reading right now of our sediment. I'm gonna get a little bit of turbidity from holding on to the ladder, but roughly about an inch.
Copy.
Looks like manganese and iron silt. So we're gonna make our way over to our first manway, which is roughly the about 1:30 position. You got a shot of that or not?
Up just a little bit. That's great.
Okay. We have sediment covering the base of that. A little bit on the upper ring. Corrosion around the outer ring. And the inner ring. Can't really tell due to the sediment. A little nodule right there in the exact center. Right here on the outer ring, that is corrosion. On there. And it goes all the way around it. Corrosion probably about 2-3%. Couple nodules on the base panel in here. Do you see them?
Yes, we can.
Up there, over there. On the weld seam, going down a little bit. Sediment adhered. More. Corrosion nodules right there. On the panel. We'll go in. As you can tell, the floor is completely covered. Make our way over to our inlet outlet, which is at the 5 o'clock position.
That's a good shot.
Okay. Looking, from what I can tell, it's getting sucked in a little bit around it. We do have blistering on the riser, corrosion on the inner portion, some sediment adhered to it, sediment going all around it. I don't know, it could be a little bit thicker sediment in this area, a few inches, but can't really tell. It just stirred up. The wall over there does have a lot of nodules on it. More nodules on the weld seam in that area, more on the panel. Coming up to our second manway, which is at the about 7 o'clock position. Anyways, looking at this manway, a little bit more sediment on the upper ring. A lot of sediment sitting on that inner. where the sediment isn't touching it, but can't really tell too much. Some blistering around the base of the panel, right down there, coming down. More nodules. And there's nothing else on the bottom. So we'll head up here in a second after we take out our base in here. Okay, a lot more nodules on the base of that panel over here. Over here. Staying consistent. All the way on the well seam, on the panels. Just in between. A little bit of the sediment that I knocked off the ladder in here. So we'll head up. As you can tell, here's the ladder. Doesn't go on the first. On the second panel, more corrosion present. Blistering. And cracking of the coating. Just heavy in that one area. Over here at the about 8 o'clock position on the second panel up. Really heavy nodules and starting to poop out, so there is pitting happening underneath. As well as the about 6 o'clock. And it's going to stay consistent going up, probably about 25% of the panels. As you can tell. Right in there. That's just actually corrosion coming off just for myself. Staying consistent on the third panel. Once again. Really textured, like underneath the coating, not certain why, but as you can tell, it has been consistent all the way up. 25% of the panels do have corrosion. It's almost like an orange peel effect that we do have going on. With the coating in here, it is not completely smooth. About 20-25% of the panels does have corrosion present. Knock some of that corrosion off, just the larger nodules. Almost like a thinner coating was put on and didn't adhere properly. In here, staying consistent all the way up. As you can tell, just I don't know if you can see that.
Yes, we can. We have a lot of bubbles, but yeah.
Let me get a there a little bit better.
Yes.
Okay. So it does stay consistent all the way around the panels going up. 25% overall does have issues. And we'll stay next to it over here, but the 6 o'clock, just so we can kind of see what it looks like. But it's consistent all the way around the tank on every single panel. So there's no need for me to go over and check out those areas, because it's all going to look like this. So they are starting to pit in underneath. Like I said, it's not a blistering. It's more of like an orange peel, like the coating didn't adhere properly inside the tank. Some more on this cracking of the coating on that actual well seam. There's not actually blistering happening. It's the coating just didn't adhere properly.
probably a good pit right in there on that one. Starting to happen. Some more over here. Some larger nodules. A couple getting knocked off just even from our bubbles. All down there. You can see all that.
Yes, we can.
And it's actually kind of just like raining corrosion in here. Because at the top, our bubbles are knocking it off. And it just stays consistent all the way up. So, it's time for a blast and recoat in the tank. All the way. All the way up. Getting close next to our water line, so we're probably about 20 feet from the roof right now. And it just stays consistent. Everywhere. A lot of staining up in this area. So here at our water line, our overflow's way up there, and I don't know how good of a shot we're gonna necessarily get of it. Let me swim over here a little bit. Can you see that?
Yes, I do. What position is that?
Can you see it better now?
No, we just lost the camera.
Oh. How's that?
That's good.
It's at the 10 o'clock.
Copy.
There's some de-alloying present on the back side of it, covering probably about 2% of it. Uniform surface corrosion, about 1%. The seam at the base has a little corrosion on it to where it meets the wall panel, but overall, the rest of the coating is in good condition. The roof, up where the vent is in the center, does have uniform surface corrosion on that, and on the panels covering probably about 5% overall, maybe a little bit more, but it's just in the center. Support ring has a little bit of corrosion on that as well, but once you get out a little bit from the center, the panels are in good condition. It's just more towards the center. The coating is a little bit thinner and does have uniform surface corrosion covering it. 5 to 10%. No de-alloying on the roof. So, and looking at our ladder in here, it did stay consistent with corrosion on every single rung going up, varying on the amount. And that's stinging right there, but we do have corrosion right there. Corrosion at the backside, right in there, and it just stays consistent on each run, probably about 20%, 15, 20% corrosion overall on that. So, at this time, we're going to stop and come back on for our next tank.
Alright, we're coming back online. We're getting ready to start our third tank. The tank is approximately 90 foot tall, 18 foot diameter. Again, prior to entering the tank, all equipment divers are inspected with a minimum 200 parts of main chlorine solution. Once again, the access hatch will be at the 12 o'clock position. 12 to 3 will be quadrant 1, 3 to 6, quadrant 2, so on and so forth. So at this time, we'll ahead and pause the video. We'll allow the diver to enter the tank. Once he's in the tank, we'll come back online and start our... Go ahead.
Alright. Starting up our survey, or sorry, our inspection down here at the bottom of the tank. I'm at the 12 o'clock position right now with the ladder. Just trying to get my buoyancy correct real quick and swim over. Actually, scratch that. I'm going to head down and check out the sediment. Looks to be only about, I'd say around between an eighth and a quarter inch deep. Very fine, silty sediment. Looks like it's got a little bit of a rust color to it. Might have some iron in it, but other than that, doesn't look to be too bad. Very, very fine. I'm going to gonna go ahead and make my way around over to the first manway. Moving around clockwise. Alright. Over to the first manway now. It is at roughly the, oh, I would say probably 4 or 5 o'clock position, 4:30 or 5. Sorry,
not a problem, take your time.
I'm starting to float up, just don't want to shoot to the surface.
That's a good shot there.
Oh, great.
Whenever you get a chance again, our camera just went out. Okay, it's back, we're good. Oh, there we go.
Got a good.
Yeah, that's a great shot.
Alright, copy that. Alright, heading back. Gonna continue around clockwise. Moving along as I'm moving around, I'm looking at the wall. Don't see any signs of the coating blistering or anything. Coating looks to be in very good condition in this area. Right down here at the bottom, no signs of any corrosion or anything like that. Alright, coming over here, we got three of them in a cluster. I got the outlet right here at the bottom. You got a shot of that?
Yep, great shot.
Copy that. Doesn't appear to be any corrosion on the outlet itself.
What position would you say that's in?
Outlet is in approximately the, I would say probably about 10 o'clock position. Same as the second manway right here. You got a picture of that one?
Yes, I do.
Alright, and then right over here, I would say probably about the 10:30, close to the 11 o'clock position. Sorry, one second. Got this pipe coming up, that is the inlet. Coming up a little bit, got some supports for the inlet, supports the coating and everything, looks like it's in very good condition, no signs of any cracking or blistering. A little bit of sediment settled here on the top, but a little bit of minor staining, other than that, looks to be in very good condition. And I'm going to do a little bit of a lap around the pipe here. Coating on the inlet itself, looks to be in very good condition. Coming to the next set of supports. Coating still appears to be in very good condition. A little bit of sediment settled up on the top. No sign of any corrosion. No cracking or blistering in the coating. Got a little bit of heavy staining as we come up towards the top of it. Looks like it rubs off a little bit. There's some heavy staining. Other than that, no signs of any cracking or anything. Coating on this other support looks to be in very good condition as well. Alright, coming to the top of the inlet. Got a good picture there.
Get back away just a little more. That's good.
Okay. On the inside of the inlet, looks like we have about 100% uniform surface corrosion. On the outer edge, looks like still in very good condition. Inlet overall, very, very good condition. Alright, back at the 12 o'clock position now. Looking at the wall here, just going to kind of gradually go around on my way up. So far, I'm headed back counterclockwise now, so I'm getting my umbilical all bunched up. Sorry, I'm letting some more air out of my suit, so I don't just shoot up on my way.
Copy that. While you're at the ladder, can you just give us a quick shot of that?
Yeah, absolutely. How's that?
That's good. Actually, back away just a little more. I'm sorry.
Okay. Alright. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and head around counterclockwise now on my way up. Looking at the walls. Got a little bit of staining, I think, right in here. Oops, sorry, stirred up a little bit of sediment there. A little bit of sediment just fell on the walls, some minor staining. Other than that, no sign of any blistering or cracking on the coating of the walls. Walls are in very good condition so far. Continuing around counterclockwise. Still the same thing. A little bit of sediment settled on the walls. It looks like staining, but it comes right up by touches, so it's just some sediment that's settled there. Other than that, no signs of any cracking, blistering, corrosion on the walls. So far, the walls are in very good condition. All the seams as well for the panel seem to be in very good condition. Might have a little bit. Nope, sorry, there's a little bit of sediment there as well. So far, no noduling or any sign of corrosion to speak of on the walls. Back to the ladder, the 12 o'clock vision. Supports for the ladder look to be in great condition as well. Check out those. Got a picture?
Yes.
Okay, thought the camera went out. Okay, going up the ladder a little bit. Gonna do another lap going back around clockwise this time as I'm on my way up. Going around, wall still appears to be in very good condition. No signs of any cracking or blistering. No signs of any corrosion or noduling starting. Coating on the wall looks to be in excellent condition all the way around aside for some minor sediment. But they've got a little bit of a water line here, part of the way up. That's probably where the sediment looks like it ends. Wall appears to be pretty clean. On up after that. A little bit of sediment settled out right here. Continuing around clockwise, other than that. Got some more sediment up on the walls here. No sign of any cracking, noduling, or corrosion or anything. No signs of any blistering in the coating. Coating appears to be in excellent condition. Back at the ladder. I'm gonna head up a little bit more. Look at the ladder. The ladder still appears to be in excellent condition as well. No signs of any corrosion. A little bit of corrosion maybe coming through on a couple of rungs where the weld seam meets the side braces. Other than that, ladder's in very good condition. Make another lap around the wall. Going counterclockwise again this time. Going around, you can see that the wall is still in very good condition. No signs of any cracking or blistering. Very little sediment to speak of on the wall in this area. Got another wall seam right here going around. Still looks to be in very good condition. Sorry, a little bit of air out of my suit. Okay. And continuing around. Again, walls are in very good condition. No signs of any cracking or blistering in the coating. This looks like a little bit of drilling when they might have put it on. Might have a little bit of blistering in this area. One second. Looks like it might have a little bit of blistering in the coating right here. A little bit of corrosion coming through. It's a very small area right in here. Other than that, it looks like mostly staining. Or it could be a possible sediment again. Got a little bit more corrosion coming through in this area as I've come up a little bit. Actually, it looks like it got a pretty uniform ring around this weld seam that has some decent corrosion or staining on it. Other than that, the wall appears to be in very good condition. No signs of any cracking in the coating. Doesn't look like there's any blistering or corrosion or noduling starting anywhere else. Wall still appears to be in very good condition. Going back to the ladder, back to the 12 o'clock position. Just got some sediment settled on some of the rungs here. Coming up a little bit. Still no signs of any cracking or blistering to speak of in the coating. Still looks to be in very good condition. I'm going to go ahead and make another lap around going clockwise this time. coating still appears to be in very good condition. Got a couple little spots here and there where a little bit might have flaked off. No sign of any corrosion in that area. A little bit of minor staining here in the coating. Other than that, no signs of any major blistering or cracking. No signs of any corrosion in this area. Coating itself and the wall both appear to be in very good condition still. A little bit of a line right here. Looks like it might have been a scratch or something where the coating was applied. Scratch underneath. Where the coating flaked off a little bit. Sorry, just got my face gun fogged. Actually, that looks like that might just be some staining. It rubs off pretty easily. Doesn't look like there's any corrosion at all in this area. Looks like just a little bit of heavy staining very intermittently. Just kind of spotted throughout. Yep, just a little bit of staining. No cracking or noduling any kind of corrosion on the wall. So continuing clockwise, but about the same thing all the way around. No signs of any cracking. No corrosion or blistering. Coating looks to be in very good condition other than a little bit of staining. Very intermittent here and there. And that's about it. Coating still appears to be in very good condition. Got another seam here. Still the same thing. Stand by. Got a line of staining that appears to be going down, up and down vertically on the side of the wall. Doesn't appear to be corrosion or anything. Other than that, coating looks like it's in good shape. I can't tell if this is blistering right here. You got a shot of this in the area?
Yes, we do. Is that just some texture underneath, Tony?
Yeah, that's what it looks like. I just can't really tell. It looks like it's texture underneath. If it is blistering, nothing's broken or anything yet or cracked through. There's no signs of any corrosion. I think it is just some texture underneath the coating. Coating still looks to be in very good condition.
Copy.
All right, going to go ahead and continue on up. A few runs, looking at the ladder. Ladder still, of course, in very good condition. Got some sediment settling on the rungs, as well as the supports connecting the ladder to the wall. All the seams and the coating on the ladder itself, as well as the ladder itself, look to be in very good condition still. I'm going to make another lap, going back around counterclockwise, looking at the wall. A little bit of sediment right there. Looking around as I'm moving counterclockwise, still seeing the same thing all the way around. A little bit of intermittent staining here and there. No signs of any cracking in the coating. No signs of any blistering or any kind of corrosion going on. So far, until I get to this area, looks like I might have a little bit of nodule starting here. Yeah, you got a picture of that?
Yes, I do. We have a green shot.
Copy that. A little bit of nodule starting right there. Looks like it's coming through the coating. Other than that, everything appears to be just some staining. Wall itself, still no signs of any cracking in the coating. No blistering, no other signs of any corrosion. Still looks to be in very good condition, other than some heavy staining intermittently throughout. Same with on the weld seam right here. Everything still appears to be in very good condition. Again, as we're moving along, you're still seeing a bunch of intermittent staining, heavier in some parts than it is in others. No signs of any cracking still, no signs of any blistering. Just a couple spots of corrosion that we saw further back there. Other than that, coating on the wall and the wall itself appear to be in very good condition. A little bit more of the texturing we saw earlier coming through right here. Nothing to worry about. Coating still in great condition in that area. And we're back up on surface. Come up to the center a little bit, get a shot of the roof. The roof itself looks to be in very good condition. No signs of any corrosion on the roof itself. Seems to be in very good condition. Got a good shot of the vent right there.
Yes.
A little bit of corrosion starting around the edge of the vent. You see a little bit of staining running down from that. Other than that, vent still appears to be in very good condition, as well as the roof. Got some corrosion starting at the lip. I'm sorry, at the joint where the roof meets the wall. I'm trying to get over to it right now. Got a little bit of staining running down from that. Just looks like it might be a little bit of uniform surface corrosion right up by the joint. And it's kind of intermittent going all the way around, it appears. A little bit of staining here and there. And judging from right here, it looks like that might have been what caused some of the staining on the wall as we go down. I'm going to picture this right here.
Yes, I do.
Okay, got a little bit of staining right above that. That might have been what caused that staining. Then we got the overflow pipe right here. I am at roughly the 9 o'clock position. Overflow pipe has a bit of staining on the top of it. Joint itself where it goes into the wall. A little bit of heavy staining on the joint itself. And the weld seal appeared to be in very good condition. Overall condition of the pipe seems to be very good. No signs of any cracking in the coating. No signs of any corrosion, just some heavy staining right there after it comes out of the wall. Coming to the back side of the overflow. I don't know if I can get the camera in. Can you see this corrosion right here on the back of it?
Yes, we can.
Okay. That looks to be the only sign of any corrosion on the overflow itself. That is a good amount back there. It's got quite a bit of corrosion coming through. The coating is blistered and cracked all the way through in that small little area. I'd say the area itself is probably about a good 6 to 8 inches long, roughly 2 to 3 inches wide. That's the only spot where there's any corrosion on the overflow itself. Inside the pipe looks to be in pretty good condition. Got some sediment settled right there inside the lip. You can see in some heavy staining. Looks like it got a little bit of blistering and cracking in the coating where you got some corrosion coming through on the inside of the overflow. Other than that, overflow itself appears to be in very good condition. Taking another quick look at the roof.
Can you just give us a quick overall of that overflow?
Yeah, absolutely. How's that?
Of the overflow?
Of the overflow, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I thought you said quick overall of the roof.
That's good right there.
Okay, you want one underneath as well?
Yep, that's good.
Alright, and I think that pretty much completes it.
Alright, we'll go ahead and pause here. We'll come back on. Alright, you're rolling.
Alright, we're coming on. We're getting ready to start our second day for the City of Peavey, Missouri. Today we're going to be doing two steel on-grade tanks. First one is approximately 56 foot high, 55 foot diameter. Steel on grade, as always, all equipment divers are disinfected with a minimum 200 parts per million chlorine solution. Next set again will be at the 12 o'clock position, 12-3 quadrant 1, 3-6 quadrant 2, so on and so forth. So at this time, we'll go ahead and pause the video. Allow the diver to enter the tank. Once he's in the tank and working, we'll come back online and start our inspection.
Alright, you're rolling.
Okay, we're coming on right now for our inspection. Just take some shots of the roof right here. You can see a little bit of bleeding and corrosion along the edges of our supports on the roof and a little bit along a couple of the seams on the panels. The rest of the panels themselves do appear to be in excellent condition though, not seeing any other issues. So really overall on the roof we're maybe looking at 1% corrosion, and that's again just on the seams and on the edges of the beams, the support beams in the tank. So we'll start here at the 12 o'clock. Was no internal ladder in the tank, so we have to stick our own in here. And you can see the heavy staining line, probably where you guys normally keep your water level. Above that line, you can see the big color difference, the nice bright white above, and then the heavier staining, dark reddish color on the side. We have these cutouts in the side of the tank right here. This is actually the overflow in the tank, and it extends from basically the 12 o'clock probably almost the 5 o'clock. Water just reaches that level and then flows out those screens. The screens themselves do appear to be in good condition. They do have some debris, like in some of the mesh, but overall, good condition. So we'll just head to the wall here, start making our way down, and see what else we have. Surface.
Copy that.
And again, right here, you can see the staining on the wall. And then as we get down, getting less of the staining, just seen on the wall seam there. Wall panel
excellent condition so far. It appears like we have some texture underneath the coating. Almost looks like blistering, but it's actually just a texture underneath that was coated over. So the wall panel is still looking to be in very good condition. Just a little bit of staining on the wall. You can see that sediment on there. Very light sediment. You can see like a manganese iron silt type of sediment hanging on the wall. So kind of hang away from the wall a little bit so we don't disturb the sediment that's on there. Just like a caulking or something hanging on the wall right there. Again, remember that texture underneath the coating? That's okay, making our way down. Weld seams and wall panels still going to be in very good condition. And we're coming closer to the floor by one more panel. And make sure we're still right below the access hatch here. Again, you can see just even getting close to the wall, kind of disturbs that sediment on there, but we'll get the best looks we can. Continuing down, still looking to be in very good condition. Not seeing any issues. Everything looking very good. That we have roughly about a half an inch of what appears to be iron silt, possibly a little bit of manganese mixed in. We can roughly about a half an inch. So we'll continue on clockwise here and see what else we have. The tank, we're not going to get very good look at the floor because there is that constant layer of sediment, across the whole bottom of the tank. As you can see across there. Well, that's just a spot of sediment. Thought maybe we'd pass over a piece of plumbing, but we'll just continue around the tank here. Let's see what else we come across. The floor and wall seam looks to be in excellent condition. Not seeing any issues there. Again, looking at our wall. Not seeing any issues. Panels look to be in very good condition. Got that layer of sediment on there. Try and hang back a little bit. Go up the wall a little bit. See what it looks like. Still staying consistent. Looks to be in very good condition. Not seeing any signs of cracking or blistering. Well, seems the same. Not seeing any coating issues. Just that light layer of sediment. As we continue up, still stay consistent. Going to be in very good condition. Sediment gets a little lighter.
we get higher, we get a little more staining as we get closer to the surface. But still, both panels and well seams looking to be in excellent condition. As we continue up, there we have some insects floating. They're coming in through the vent screen or the hatch. Here we are.
Hey Tom, sorry to interrupt you. Did you see the manway while you were down at the bottom?
It's going to be over, I don't know if there's a pullback, seeing one. Over at about the 11:55, so it's going to be ahead of us yet.
Oh, I copy that. My bad. Sorry, go ahead.
Not a problem. And again, just want to point out, we do have some insects getting into the tank. You can see here, we've seen a couple floating just before we got to the surface. Another one here. Possibly need a, and again, above us on the right, they really stand out. Possibly could use a gasket on the hatch or a smaller mesh on our vent or overflow screens. Again, the roof of this area looks to be in good condition. Again, just that little bit of corrosion on the edges of the beams and a little bit on some of the seams of the panels. But the panels themselves still looking to be in excellent condition. So we'll head on down. And as we make our way down, still looking very consistent. Have your staining up higher here. And then as we continue down, turns into the sediment hanging on the wall. But again, our wall panels are going to be in very good condition. Looks like we have just a small nodule right in front of us there. First one I've seen so far. Continuing down, right now we're heading down in a 6 o'clock area. And again, everything's still looking very consistent. Not seeing any coating issues. Weld seams and panels still very good condition. Just that sediment hanging on the walls. Still looking to be in good condition. Looking very uniform. Still not seeing any issues. A little bit heavier staining in the spots. Does appear like we have a couple nodules here again in this area, over there, and a couple more over here. Pretty small nodules, not even the size of a dime. And here we are coming back to the floor. And the floor and wall seam looks to be in good condition. Looks like we have that iron silt layer of sediment still in here. Looks to be about 3/4 of an inch in this area. So it really hasn't changed a whole lot from the front to the back of the tank. Yeah, this is roughly a 6 o'clock position. And heading out to the center here a little more. Kind of a lighter layer. Probably only about a
out here. And again, really not gonna see a whole lot going on with the floor. We do have a pad eye right in the very center of the tank. It's probably the only thing we're gonna be able to distinguish on the floor. And that looks to be in good condition, no corrosion or anything there. So that was the center of the tank. We head down right there at the center. Try and get a good look how deep it is right there. Consistent as well, roughly about half an inch of that iron silt sediment. So head back out to the wall, continue around. Roughly 7:30. Looking at a wall. Again, just a light layer of sediment. Yeah, iron silt and manganese. Very easy to disrupt. So we'll just kind of hang back again. But again, not seeing any coating issues. Floor and wall seam appears to be in good condition. Coming up about the 9 o'clock. Go ahead and set up the wall in this area again. See if we have any changes. Should be staying consistent. A little nodule right there on the wall. So far haven't even seen, not even nowhere near to 1% of corrosion in the tank. Really, it's actually looking to be in very good condition. Just a few small nodules so far. And again, our wall looking to be in a very good condition. Just that layer of sediment. A little bit coming off the wall right there. And then as we get higher, we get less sediment, more staining. Coating still looking to be excellent condition. Not seeing any issues. And the stain very consistent. Again, have your staining up higher as we get closer to the water line. Still not seeing any issues. A little bit of bleeding coming down from above the waterline, so the darker staining is. Right there. Bleeding coming down from the roof and wall seam. Again, in this area, a little bit of corrosion on some of the seams of the panels. And again, on the supports on the edges. Again on the wall,
We got some insects adhered to the wall above the water line. Everything else, though, looking to be in good condition. So just make our way back down. And again, looking to be in excellent condition. Besides any coating issues. Well, that looks like the coating ran a little bit down that seam when they applied it. Beginning to do more sediment as we head down. Gonna get some texture underneath the coating. In good condition. Not seeing any problems. Is that layer of sediment on the wall? Everything still. Very good condition. Not seeing any problems. So we keep on heading down. Everything's still very good condition. Well teams, well panels. Another small nodule right in front of us there. Right there. Very scattered and small. Some more right below us. There. Right below us here at what we call the 1130. We have our inlet outlet. Okay. Going for a closer look. It has a recessed basin around it with a bunch of heavier material, nodulating and some metal fragments. Settled in there. The basin does have some nodulating in it, like you can see just below us right there. Right around it here, you can see some of these larger flakes that have blown out. Inside, you do have a lot of sediment staining, but overall looks to be in good condition. Riser itself, you can see just that staining on there. As well as on the outside, do have some nodulating around this seam and towards the base. Probably looking at about 5% corrosion. Other than that, looks to be in good condition. The weld seam around has some sediment around there from what is exposed. All looks to be in good condition. And again, just some heavier fragments that have settled out around the inlet here. And just past that, on the wall, we have our manway, roughly the 1155. Let me know, we gotta get you out of that.
Look up just a little bit. Perfect, great picture.
Okay. We do have a bigger nodule to the right of the manway, right there. Has some minor pitting below that. Also, some little nodules along this belt seam. Going around the manway, you can see on the bottom edge of the weld seam. Also some nodules on the door panel itself.
From what I can see, the gasket appears to be in good condition. We do have some sealing on the door and some sediment on that inner ring there. The rest of the inner ring, though, appears to be in good condition. Not seeing any major issues with that. We're probably looking at 3% corrosion on the manway overall. And then outer weld seam looks to be in good condition. I got some nodules up there around that as well, but nothing of really major concern. So we'll head on up. Take a final look at our wall as we head up. Again, nothing in any issues. Sediment down towards the bottom. As we head up, I gotta find it. Just the stain. And between the two, really nothing. There's a section where a little bit on the weld seams, and other than that, a little bit of texture under the coating. Still looking to be in very good condition. All looking to be in very good condition as we continue up. Nice white coating, a little bit of sediment on the weld seam. But still looking to be in very good condition. Some more texture underneath with some sediment in this area. Again, all looking to be in very good condition. Next weld seam again, very good condition. Because our weld panel, wall panels. Now we're getting into just that staining on the wall. As we continue up to the heavier staining and some texture again under the coating. To some stray welds. Got some staining on them. And some heavier staining. As we continue up to the waterline, and the heaviest thing again right here at the waterline. So, I should conclude this tank. Go ahead and pause the video and come back online for our next tank.
You're on.
Alright, we're getting ready to do our last tank. This tank again is approximately 56 foot high. This one is the smaller of the two tanks, approximately 25 foot diameter, steel on grade tank. As always, Sully Cummins divers are disinfected with the minimum 200 parts per million chlorine solution before entering the tank. Again, the access hatch will be at the 12 o'clock position, 12 to 3 quadrant 1, 3 to 6 quadrant 2, so on and so forth. So again, we'll go ahead and pause the video, allow the diver to enter the tank, get situated, once he's in the tank, we'll come back on and start doing our inspection.
You're rolling.
Alright, we're coming on to do our final tank. Just want to point out this upper edge of the angle line, you can see all that uniform surface corrosion.
And it goes all the way around the tank on that piece of angle iron. We also have some corrosion starting on the seams of the panels and again on the supports. We're looking at about 3% corrosion on the roof, mainly just uniform surface corrosion, no really major issues. Also, we have our support ring at the top here.
Just want to point that out. Do have some corrosion on the inside back there. Nothing serious, a little bit of delamination of the coating in a couple spots, and just a bunch of heavier staining above the waterline like we've seen in the last tank. Then some heavier areas where bleeding has come down from above.
So, a quick look towards the center here.
You can see again, some more of the uniform surface corrosion starting on the supports going across,
and then on the seams themselves, you can see a little bit of corrosion starting. So, let's get around our ladder here. We'll start making our way down.
Copy that.
Sir.
Copy.
Just below the water line, we have some heavier sediment staining on the wall panel. You can see that right there. And then as we start making our way down, our wall panels look to be in very good condition. Again, some sediment staining on the panels, but I don't really see any other issues. Good. You can see the unevenness after the previous coating, the paint and stuff that was in the metal before, but the new coating looks to be in very good condition. As we keep heading down, our weld seams as well look to be in very good condition. Not seeing any problems. There, very light sediment on the walls. Just go ahead and stay back from the walls again as we head down. But still looking at the panels, still looking to be in very good condition. Seen any problems? Small little nodule right there in front of us. Sediment getting a little heavier on the walls as we continue down, but the panels still look to be in very good condition. Still no problems to note. Looks like something had fallen from above and made a line down the wall panel as it fell down. Again, our wall panels and weld seams looking to be in very good condition. Coming up to the floor now. We do have a small nodule right there at the floor of the wall seam. Looks like we have, again, try and get down closer. We do have about an inch and a half of iron silt sediment in this tank. So again, we're not going to get any good shots to the floor. Here's our center pad eye. It has a little bit of corrosion on that. Overall condition, it's the only thing we're going to be able to really note with the floor. So we'll head back to the wall. Bearings where I'm at here. We have our inlet outlet over here at roughly the 3 to 330 position. I know we got a good shot of that.
Great picture, thank you.
Okay. There's about a 3-foot riser on the inlet outlet. You can see the floor is exposed right around it. A couple of small nodules around that base pad and weld seam. Then we do have some nodules down here on the connection for the riser. And a couple more on the back side there. Some staining on the riser. There's no major issues. We're looking at maybe 2-3% corrosion. Some more staining on the inside. You can see a staining on the top edge of the riser here. Really no issues with that. Just that little bit of corrosion down at the base pad and then at the connection where the riser meets. Again, looking at our wall. Here at 3 o'clock area, so we got a little scratch right above the inlet here. It's starting to corrode there a little bit, but looking around,
not seeing any other issues. We'll go ahead and hit up the wall in the 3 o'clock area right here. There we have some stray welds with some sediment sitting on them, but no other issues. A little heavier stain right above the inlet outlet right here. So that's all that material is right there. It's just a stain from the water coming in. And then here's some stray welds, which have some sediment on them. It does not appear to have any other issues. So we'll head on up. I'm looking back and forth here. And a little heavier stain right above the inlet. Yeah, possibly a little bit of corrosion. Some of these spots are staining, but some of them are also little nodules in there. That's right above the inlet. Probably just from the water moving up and down. Causing a little bit of issue with the coating in this area. It just appears to be this 3-foot span right above the inlet. All of it seems to be contained right between there, but it does continue up the wall panel. You continue up, just all these little spots. So overall, we're probably looking at 3-5% of the panel on the wall. But again, just seems to be staying right above the inlet outlet so far. I'm kind of trailing off as we get closer to surface. A little bit more here towards the 4 o'clock. Another bigger area. Some corrosion starting. Doesn't appear to be any pitting, but corrosion is starting to show through. And extending up towards the 4:30 there a little bit. So the panels looking to be in good condition though. We're continuing up in the 4 o'clock. Closer to the surface. And the trail's off. A little bit more here, but not as concentrated. It was lower. And then some more bleeding. And then heavier staining on the walls. Up closer to the waterline. And that's actually closer to the 5 o'clock area. We have our overflow. Another shot of that.
Copy that picture, thank you.
Okay, we do have a little bit of corrosion starting on the underside. The overflow and a little bit on the top edge of the flare out up there. Maybe looking at 2% corrosion overall on that. Putting it on our support ring here, you can see the uniform surface corrosion on the underside. Extending around, and then again on that upper angle iron where the roof and wall seam meet, you can see the uniform surface corrosion continuing on that all the way around the tank. And again on our roof, on our panel seams, you can see some corrosion starting, and again on our supports, like we have discussed earlier. So we'll head down here, 6 o'clock area. Let's see what we have. And up those little spots. Corrosion as we head down. A few more. Rest of the wall. So far looking good. A little bit of sediment on those stray welds. Bit of sediment seating and the wall panels again.
starting, as you can see. So there's a little bit of corrosion mixed in with that sediment. Probably looking at a little higher percent, maybe up to 10% corrosion on the panels. You can see some more of those little bigger nodules mixed in with the sediment there. Moving through those darker spots. And there's a little bit smaller ones mixed in back here as we keep heading down. Again, doesn't appear to be pitting in. Corrosion just appears to be starting. Still small specks of that corrosion mixed in with that sediment. Sediment getting a little heavier as we get closer to the bottom. You can see a few of those little bigger nodules, darker spots sticking out. And coming up to the bottom, you have some nodules on that part of the wall seam. Scattered out. Head down a little bit here. See if we can get depth on the 7th. Back at the 6 o'clock. Again, we're looking at still a consistent inch and a half. Back here at the 6, so staying pretty consistent. So head over towards the 9. A couple bigger nodules right here on the wall towards the 9 o'clock. And right here at about the 10:30, we have our manway.
Up just a little bit. Great picture, thank you.
Okay.
Sorry, you said that was 10 o'clock position?
Yeah, 10:30.
Copy, thank you.
You can see the sediment built up there. That's basically what we're looking at on the floor as well. About an inch and a half. Do have a little bit of corrosion right in the center there. And up with a test spigot on the outside. And it's corroding on the inside. You can see along the weld seam here, all these little nodules starting to show through all the way around that outer weld seam. And also on the inside there, where the gasket is, you can see the nodules starting. And a couple stray ones in the door. We're probably looking at about 3-5% corrosion on the manway. So we'll go ahead and head up the wall in this area. See what we got. Just brush away a little bit of the sediment so you can get a good look at the wall. These nodules continuing in this area as well. Again, not appear to be pitting to the metal, so they're just starting. But they are getting pretty concentrated in areas. As you can see, as we start heading up, continuing up. So definitely something you're going to want to keep an eye on and monitor. Check the progression of it. Doesn't take off on you. Again, you can see it as we continue up the wall. As well, a little bit behind us, it's 9 o'clock. You can see that whole area. That's all the corrosion. Just like in front of us here. Then looking towards the 12. Not really seeing any issues. Continuing up, you can see the corrosion continuing in this area right in front of us. And back a little bit here, so it's a 9. Continuing as we get on the walls. Back and forth here, spanning from the 11. Again, back to the 9. Back and forth, up the wall. Still continuing as we keep making our way up. Getting to see a little bit more staining on the wall as we make our way up. So you can see the corrosion continuing. Probably be looking at a little higher percent. Maybe 15 to 20% corrosion on the wall panels. And then kind of trails off. Maybe closer to the surface, but the staining gets a little more. But you still can see those little bigger, darker spots mixed in there. So the corrosion continuing up to the surface. And then above the waterline, you can see the darker staining up there. You can form surface corrosion starting on the underside of the support ring, as well as on that upper angle iron of wall and roof meet up. And all the way around the tank. So, at this time, that'll conclude this tank. On behalf of the Potable Services, we'd like to thank you for using our company. Hopefully you do again in the future.